Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print the odd numbers by using for loop in Python. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can do this. So let's get started. So first we will be getting the number n as the input from the user, because till which we will be printing that odd number. So let n be that number equal to int of input, enter n. And don't forget to add here int, because this is of type integer, and if you just mention only input, this will be of type string and it will throw an error. So don't forget to add int. So after this, let me just have a for loop template. So it's going to be for I in range, the starting value, which in my case it is going to be 1, because the first odd number is 1 and 0 is a neutral number. So always begin from 1, comma n, which is the number that we are getting from the user, and you need to put here n plus 1, because by default the range in for loop is n minus 1. If you just mention here n, it will take the value only till n minus 1, but we also need to include that nth number. So for doing that, you need to add here n plus 1, and after this let me just print I. Okay, this is just a normal for loop, so let me just check if it is working. And after that, let me just tell you how you can improvise this code by just adding a number. That's it. That's the change that we'll be doing to print only the odd numbers. So let me just go with 10. So here you can see I'm getting 1 to 10. That's cool. So the single change that I told you is, in the for loop syntax, we will be having here a third parameter. All right. This is going to be the increment. So this is going to be the starting value, the ending value, and this is going to be the increment. So by default, the increment is going to be 1. So if I just put 1 over here and save it, and if I run this code, I'll be getting the same output, because by default the increment is 1. It doesn't change. So why we are getting the numbers 1 to 10 is because of this increment of 1. So what happens is that first the I value is 1, I gets printed, it gets incremented by 1. So basically this happens to our I. Should be like this, I equal to I plus 1. So it comes here, after one gets printed, it's going to be I equal to I plus 1, I value is 1, it's going to be I equal to 1 plus 1, and I value becomes 2, 2 gets printed, again it comes here, I equal to 2 plus 1, 3 gets printed, it goes here, I equal to 4 plus 1, 4 gets printed. So it goes on. So for printing the odd numbers alone, we can just change this increment to, that's it. So now what will happen is that the same thing, first 1 will be getting printed, prints 1, I value is 1, it goes here, I equal to I plus 2, because this time the increment is 2. So what happens here, I equal to 1 plus 2, which becomes 3, 3 gets printed, it goes here, I equal to 3 plus 2, 5 gets printed, then for incrementation, I equal to 5 plus 2, 7 gets printed. So by having this increment as 2, we are basically skipping the even numbers. So here you can see, right, 1, 3, 5, 7. We are skipping 2, 4, 6. By skipping, I meant is that we are not getting that values because of this increment value of 2. Because adding 2 to an odd number will definitely give an odd number again. See, here you can see, right, 1 plus 2 gives 3, 3 plus 2 gives 5, 5, 5 plus 2 gives 7, 7 plus 2 will give 9. So there is no chance of getting an even number over here. So this is the trick. So let me just now run this, clear it and run this. I'll go with 10. Here you can see I'm getting the odd numbers alone. So this is the first way. This is the easiest and the fastest way. I would recommend you to follow this method. And anyways, I will be showing you the second method also. You can just have it for knowledge or something. So I'll just remove the increment. I will leave it to the default increment as 1. And what I will do is I will just have a if condition, and we will check if that I value is even or odd number. Okay, let me just go here, if, and we need to have the print inside the if. So just come here, press tab. Okay, you need to be careful with the indentation. This is 1 tab space, here 2 tab space from the starting. Alright, so here we will check if our I value is odd or even. So I will just have I modulus of 2 equality 1. Okay. So the modulus operator basically returns the remainder. So for example, 10 modulus of 2 will give the remainder as 0, because 10 is absolutely divisible by 2, so we don't have any remainder. And for every even number that we perform modulus by 2 will surely give 0, because even numbers are perfectly divisible by 2. For example, if we take 8 remainder is 2, 4 remainder is 2, because those are even numbers. But in case of odd numbers, for example, let me go with 11. 11 is not divisible by 2 and the remainder is going to be 1. 5 is not divisible by 2 and the remainder is going to be 1, because 4 is divisible, 1 is extra, remainder is 1. And 7 is not divisible by 2, the remainder is going to be 1. So whenever we do modulus operation by 2 for an odd number, we will be getting the remainder as 1. This is assured. So whenever our I value is odd, we will be getting the remainder as 1. The condition becomes true and our odd number gets printed over here. So for example, 1 comes here and yeah, 1 is odd, 1 modulus of 2 is 1, condition is true, 1 gets printed. 2 comes here, 2 modulus of 2 is 0, 0 equal to 1, condition is false, it doesn't get printed. Then I plus plus, 3 comes here, 3 modulus of 2, which is 1, and this condition is true, 3 gets printed. So by this way, whenever we are having odd numbers, only this condition will become true and we will be printing it. And when it's an even number, this condition will fail and we won't be printing it. So this is in a nutshell how this is going to work. This is more complex, you need to have a if. This is just putting a comma. So the first method always is the best method, I would say. I will go with 10. Yeah, 13579. So this is how you print the odd numbers by using for loop in Python. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Python, C, C++, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries, 3D animation using Blender. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.